204,000, that's how many jobs were added to the US economy in October, nearly double Wall Street estimates.
Yeah, this was a really strong jobs report. There was a good deal of uncertainty around this report because of the shutdown, the effects it might have had on jobs. We did see on the household survey side, which accumulates data in a different way, there was a huge drop there. But then again, the participation rate dropped sharply, so the unemployment rate was not impacted. So confusing all put together, but of course the NFP, the non-farm payrolls being very strong, took the market by surprise, and we are seeing the dollar stronger.
We also saw data from September and August revised upwards, signs that the economy could be stronger than previously thought.
I'd argue that employment is a bit of a lagging indicator, but the important thing here, of course, is Fed watching. And this is really putting back the sort of the fear of the taper into markets. We have bonds selling off very strongly, as of course this will bring back the idea or the notion that they may move as soon as December.
And all that could translate into a stronger dollar.
It's a bit of a mixed reaction, I think. If you look at, for example, dollar yen, we have risk off, which tends to be supportive of the yen, so dollar yen downside, but then we have bonds selling off very strongly, which supports dollar yen upside. Dollar yen's been all over the map, so I'm curious how that one settles the week and goes into next week, which signal proves stronger. I think there has been a tendency for risk off to see that one lower. I think the more unambiguous trade here is this is a threat to global liquidity, and we're seeing the commodity currencies sharply weaker against the dollar. So let's see if that one continues into next week.